Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome again to health issues, health conditions. Last time when I met with you, we talked about your heart. I hope you have today a better heart, clean heart, increased of iman and yaqeen with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And also you thought about it and you did something like increased walking, decreased amount of food, or you drink more water. I hope that you did something to change the condition of your heart. But the most importantly is, and you increased your iman and you have increased your an iman in your heart. Today we will talk to you about the diabetes, one of the health conditions that affecting too many people around the globe. It is very dangerous, easily preventable and treatable conditions that we can take some tips that is Islamically correct, Islamically recommended, that we can use it to prevent or to delay or to treat diabetes. Diabetes is a disease that may affect every part of the body. If we look at the screen, that can affect the brain, can affect your eyes, your heart, your other systems, and the complications of it is so expensive and so costly to treat, and also it's very stressful to your health conditions. Recently, the studies that presented numbers that they are very frightening numbers, actually. In the United States only, there are 17 million people, they are complaining of diabetes. And the diabetic patients are increasing day after day. And there are also pre-diabetic conditions. And this is most important to know about it. I need you to read about that pre-diabetic conditions. We talked about it before, that you control your weight. Do not allow your weight to increase, because overweight, it is like equal pre-diabetic. When we increasing our weight, we may be exposed to diabetes. And that pre-diabetic stage easily preventable and reversible, that we can control our risk factors, reduce it, and that will delay the problems with diabetes. Now, it is the fastest growing disease problems in the world, across the globe. There are many people now are getting diabetes. It is also frightening that a lot of children diagnosed with diabetes recently because of lack of activities. We leave our children to video games, sitting on the computer, using the computer for hours, and if they are not using computer, they are watching TV, they are not involved in physical activities, in sports program as they need to. And this is the responsibility of parents, the responsibility of schools, teachers. It is a community responsibility that we should prevent, work together to prevent these problems from increasing. Diabetes is the leading cause of blindness in the United States because it affects the eyes. It is the leading cause of the end-stage kidney diseases. When you hear about kidney failure, people that they have a lot of dialysis, especially in underdeveloped countries, many people that they have these problems because of diabetes. It is responsible about 60% of traumatic lower limb amputations. Amputation is to cut part of the leg, and that's because of diabetes. Infection, in the infection is not easily treated, and have open wounds, and the open wounds lead to maybe infection of the bones or other risk problems, and it leads to the amputation or lose of part of the limb or the whole limb because of diabetes. How can we deal with that? How can we handle that? It is scary, but alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us things that we can fight all these diseases and work with it. It is easily preventable, not easily preventable, but needs commitment, needs you to take charge of your health and think about your health, because if you don't think about it, plan to live a healthy life, the problems might be very close to you and you are not dealing with it. Now, we talked about it before, if you remember, and about increased weight. And increased weight is one of the leading cause of diabetes. So that you control your weight and measure it, don't just estimate it. I would recommend that you measure your weight at least once a month to know, are you increasing or decreasing, and you control it, not to leave it forever. And now, poor diet, that means lower fiber intake, high glycemic load, improper fat intake, that means the people that are taking a lot of fat in their food, and that you need to eliminate that, so you reduce the risk factors for that diabetes. Also smoking, and we talked about smoking before. Smoking is part of the risk factors, and if you reduce or eliminate or stop smoking, you will have low risk factor to diabetes. Researchers in the United States presented that a lot of people that they are involved in exercises program or diet programs, they have low risk factors to diabetes. So you need to do something about the conditions. Every one of us now is vulnerable to increased weight because of the habits of eating. We eating a lot of junk food. We eating a lot of carbohydrates. Sugar in our food is increasing, and we need to control that consumption of sugar in diet, of carbohydrates. And you need to eliminate, and not to eliminate it, but to reduce it to the amount only required for your system. If we increase that, that will increase our risk to increase the intake of carbohydrates, will increase your vulnerability to such disease. Can we prevent it completely? And no, the answer is no. But we can eliminate and reduce the risk of diabetes if we don't have it. If we have it, we should continuously check our condition, diabetic level, or the sugar level. And because some people, they have diabetes, they know that they are diagnosed with diabetes, and they are not checking their blood sugar regularly. This is need to be checked regularly, especially if you are fasting. You need also to check that every day. Make sure that you're controlling at the level with the recommendation of your doctor. Check your skin for any breakdown of the skin. Early treatment of the skin breakdown can be easily treated rather than waiting for the wound to get to be infected, and it'll be hard to treat. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, لِبَدَنِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقَّ, that your body has rights upon you to prevent disease, and if you have it, to treat it. because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the disease and created the cure for it, and we should seek the cure for each disease. Now, the topic in this meeting was about diabetes. But you know that diabetes now is a major problem. You need to educate yourself, educate your family, educate your neighbor about it. You may ask your local mosque to have maybe diabetic night. And these are maybe crazy ideas, maybe out of thinking. But talk to your imam, tell him that we need to talk about diabetes today. It's affecting many of our community, and we need to teach them about diabetes. And invite a nurse or a physician or someone know about diabetes to teach the community so that we can prevent that. It is preventable, we can control it, but needs commitment, needs directions to the people what to do. One of the best thing also to do for diabetes is to increase your physical activity. The staying still, doing nothing, doing no exercises at all, that will increase the risk of complications from diabetes. So if you are pre-diabetic or already diagnosed with diabetes, you need to start a physical activity program that can help your muscles, your bones to continue healthy, and to check your blood sugar level regularly and increase your activity accordingly. I hope that you got some points to prevent diabetes or to control it. Please check your blood sugar today, even though that you are not diagnosed with diabetes, so you make sure that you are free of it. Do every effort to prevent it, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of us from such things. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. And we will be meeting next time in another topic. Till that time, enjoy it. Have a good iman in your heart and increase your activity level. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Welcome again to Health Issues. And I hope last time we talked about diabetes, and before we talked about the heart conditions, and there was a general theme in both of these diseases. They communicate together, or they are interdependent somehow, because if you prevent one properly, you're preventing the other by increasing your activity level, by stop smoking, by reducing your weight. These are all major factors that can prevent this type of diseases. And in this time, in this meeting, we will talk about another factor that have a lot of people now complaining of. It is the high blood pressure. The high blood pressure is a major problems in global society now because of the stress that we have, because of the change of the lifestyle. A lot of stress is around us and increasing your tension. The people are stressed out. Everybody say that you raised my blood pressure. And statistically, a lot of people now are killed or died because of the increased blood pressure. It is another health hazard that we need to take care of it and to control it. It is easy controllable. And again, if you continuously measure it, control it, and do a few things to change your lifestyle, it might be very simple to treat or to control. How many around you complaining high blood pressure? How many you know that they are taking medication for blood pressure? And if you ask them how much activity that you do, how much you weigh, or such questions of healthy lifestyle, you will find most of them are living risky lifestyle. As I mentioned, about 49,000 Americans killed in 2002 because of the high blood pressure. About 1 of three from the American society complaining of high blood pressure. This is, yes, numbers in the United States, but probably you will have these numbers around the globe. If you search it, you'll find a lot of people that complaining of high blood pressure. High blood pressure comes from very simple, if you think about it, the vascular system or your arteries and veins are getting smaller, restricted, hard, and that increase the tension during the circulation of the blood in your system. That increase the demand on your heart to work, decrease the blood supply to areas, and sometimes because of that, that's called atherosclerosis, or the hardening of the vascular system, it can be blocked somewhere, maybe affecting your lung or your heart or your brain, and these are all very high risk issues that you, with your attention, with your awareness of your health, you can prevent that, and also you can bring the community around you to prevent that, and in the general community, and we decrease the cost of medications and dependence on medicine. We can decrease that as well. First, eating habits. We talked about eating. Don't eat too much. Don't eat too much. Again, don't eat too much. You need to reduce this amount of food that you're taking in your system. When you eat the good food, and the good food will reduce the risk of your blood pressure. So to take care of the blood pressure, again, we said that many times. Probably those who are in the studio right now, they got tired of me saying stop smoking, stop smoking, stop smoking. This is the things that cause the blood pressure to change from easy controllable to be hard and cause complications, may increase the complications and put your life in danger. If you are high blood pressure and also your smoker, cannot match. If you are diagnosed with high blood pressure and you're still smoking, you are practicing a risky behavior against your health. And Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam warned you about that. That لِبَدَنِكَ عَلَيْكَ حَقٍّ. Do not hurt yourself, please. So that now the high blood pressure is, you can decrease it. First, stop smoking. What is the second one? Again, will be stop overeating. Stop overeating. And so overeating will also increase your blood pressure. And exercise. And the people that they are watching us for several times now, find me repeating three things regularly with each disease. We talked about heart disease, and we said stop smoking, stop overeating, and exercise. We talked about diabetes, and we said stop smoking, stop overeating, and exercise. Today we are talking about high blood pressure. And again, I'll repeat the same thing. Repetition sometimes is good, so that you know that these are risky factors. If you eliminate it, you will take control of your health. Stop smoking, stop overeating, and exercise. Now, since we're talking about exercise, so how much we exercise? What are the things that we need really to do? The weight loss, it depends on two factors. That to reduce your weight depends on the amount of food that you're taking and the amount of activity that you're doing. If you reduce your weight, if you lose weight, you will also control your blood pressure at least by 20% or 20 millimeter mercury. That 20% of the blood pressure can be controlled by reducing your weight. The diet, and if you see on the screen, you saw it a while ago, is DASH diet. DASH is the diet program that a lot of experts from Harvard University, from Duke University, produced that DASH diet. If you read it, if you read it carefully, you'll find most of it was ordered by Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You know, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that مَا تَرَكْتُ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فِيهِ خَيْرُكُمْ إِلَّا وَأَمَرْتُكُمْ بِهِ. The meaning of it, the meaning of the hadith is that Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never left anything that has good for us, that, and he just told us about it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about everything that's good for us. And when you read the DASH or the DASH diet that produced by this high expertise in the medical field, they telling you that how much to eat, how to control your diet, how many times that you eat, what type of fasting that you need to fast, all of that addressed in our sunnah. So following the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam will also reduce your risk for heart disease, for high blood pressure, or for other health conditions. One of the things that most of you know about high blood pressure is the salt intake. Salt intake. And the salt intake is very risky for high blood pressure because it's increased, also increased the high blood pressure. It is very easy to prepare your food without salt. And if you like to add some, just add a little bit of it. You don't have to make it very salty so that you're not able to eat it or will danger your life. And this is another concept that we're introducing in this session, is the salt intake. We talked about the sugar intake with the diabetes. You need to control your sugar intake. And in this session, we talk about salt intake. The salt intake will increase your blood pressure, so please be careful of the amount of salt that you have on your diet. Don't increase it too much. Yes, it sometimes make it very tasty and nice, but it might be risky for your blood pressure. Exercise. Exercise is the one of the defense mechanism against your high blood pressure. If you exercise regularly, and if you do your exercise every day, you will reduce the amount of the risk, the complications that produced by high blood pressure. Walk. How much walk we need. I would urge you first to start very slow, and we will have other sessions to talk about exercises, the amount of it and how much you need. But start first. Most of the people, they don't have that starting or the initiation. You need to initiate it. How you initiate it? I would urge you after Salat al-Fajr, after you pray Fajr, walk for 15 to 20 minutes. 15 to 20 minutes. Do that regularly for 2 weeks. And then increase that gradually, inshallah. And let us meet again next time. Tell me that you walked for 15, 20 minutes, because I need you to do it, really. We talked about activity. Activity can control your heart disease, diabetes, reduce your high blood pressure, can prevent a lot of things. Why not walk? Let us do that walking, and let us walk together to a healthy lifestyle. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala get us all together to walk to the Jannah, inshallah, while we have healthy heart of Iman and Yaqeen. And till next time, make dua for me and I will make dua for you. And let us meet together with a good health and Iman. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.